When the Hubble Space Telescope was launched into orbit in 1990, it represented decades of work, an investment of more than $1 billion, and a leap forward in the field of astronomy, the likes of which had not been seen since the invention of Galileo's telescope in the 1600s. There was just one problem. The telescope didn't work right. As soon as the first images were received from Hubble, a problem became obvious. Instead of the sharp, detailed pictures scientists had been expecting, the telescope was producing incredibly blurry images. The cause of the issue was rapidly identified. The Hubble's primary mirror had been polished to the wrong shape. Although it was one of the most precisely finished mirrors ever made, the outer edge was too flat by 2200 nanometers. That's about 1/450th of a millimeter, or 1/11,000th of an inch. This tiny flaw produced catastrophic results with regards to Hubble's functionality. Fortunately, lessons had been learned from the Hubble's predecessor, the Orbiting Astronomical Observatory 2, nicknamed Stargazer. Stargazer had only collected information for 4 years before it was shut down, after the quality of its observations gradually deteriorated. To prevent this, Hubble had been specially designed so that astronauts in space could conduct repairs and replace or upgrade parts. Servicing missions for the telescope had already been planned, and the first one was scheduled for 1993. That gave NASA 3 years to invent and prepare a solution. A backup mirror had been made, but launching it and replacing the Hubble telescope's mirror while in orbit would be wildly impractical. Instead, the team at NASA designed a new component to go over the mirror, which would sharpen the focus of the blurry images at the source. This has been compared to giving the Hubble a pair of glasses because it works similarly. This new component, called the Corrective Optics Space Telescope Axial Replacement, or COSTAR, was launched on December 2, 1993. Over the course of 11 days, the astronauts installed the component, and by January of 1994, NASA declared the repair a complete success. Hubble could see. Starting out with a huge blunder damaged Hubble's reputation, but once the fix was implemented and the Hubble telescope began to produce the stunning, high-quality images it was built for, the benefits of the space telescope became obvious, and the project became incredibly popular. Every component since 1990 has been built with modifications to correct for the flaw in Hubble's primary mirror, and a total of 5 missions have been flown to repair, upgrade, or replace systems on the telescope, allowing it to continue to function long past its original target of 15 years collecting data. The last servicing mission took place in 2009, and at present there are no plans for any more repairs in the future. The Hubble telescope will continue to collect data for as long as its instruments last, and is generally expected to work until 2030 at least. Hopefully, by the time the Hubble ceases observation for good, there will be something to take its place. Scientists have been hard at work building the next generation of space telescopes, such as the James Webb Telescope that commenced operations in summer of 2022, so that no matter how long Hubble lasts, we will always have a way to look at the stars.